بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. One of the most worrying things is that on the day of Qiyamah, we will be alone, questioned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about ourselves. Yet on earth, we are worried about everyone else. The plot of shaitan is to divert you and I from the main day. The main day is mentioned in the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam many times. It is known by so many different names. Many of them are scary, highlighting to us the seriousness of that day. Allah Almighty speaks about it, and inshallah today I want to go through a few of the verses of how we will be alone fighting our own case. Nobody will be able to worry about another, be it a spouse or a child or a brother or blood or a friend or whatever. Each one will be worried about himself, including the prophets of Allah, besides Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, who is going to be speaking about the ummah and fighting on behalf of the ummah. Kullun yaqulu nafsi nafsi. Everyone is going to be saying, me, myself, myself, I'm worried about myself, I'm worried about myself. In fact, Allah says on that day, يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ وَأُمِّهِ وَأَبِيهِ وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَبَنِيهِ لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مِّنْهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ شَأْنٌ يُغْنِيهِ. Allah says on that day, everyone will run away. Each person run away from his brother. A person, a man, a woman, whoever it may be, a person will run away from his own sibling, from his or her mother and father, and from his or her partner. Run away. Each one will have his own issues that he will realize, I need to defend myself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَوْمَ تَأْتِي كُلُّ نَفْسٍ تُجَادِلُ عَن نَفْسِهَا. On that day, every soul will come and fight his or her own case. Fighting, literally worried, what did I do? What on earth did I do? Allah warned me about a day of judgment and he told me, worry about yourself. You are going to come to us. وَكُلُّهُمْ آتِيهِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فَرْدًا. Each one of them, meaning us, is going to come in front of Allah alone. You know what you did in your life. You know how much muck you've been in. You know what sins you've committed, how far you've been from Allah. You know absolutely everything. But guess what? There will be so many things that you may have forgotten. And at times there are sins we commit without realizing we're committing a sin. And Allah says, we told you to worry about yourself. One of the favors of Allah is seeking forgiveness. That will get you a long way. Tuba liman wujida fi sahifatihi istighfaran kathira. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, give good news of paradise to the one in whose books a lot of istighfar will be found on the day of judgment. Every little while, istighfar, istighfar, istighfar. After every salah, do your istighfar. Do your istighfar on a daily basis. Why do you think the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam sought forgiveness up to 100 times a day when he did not need it? He didn't need it. Ma'soom. He was clear. He didn't need it. Because if we follow his example, we will also be doing istighfar 100 times a day. And not just pay lip service to it, but we space it out through the day and we think about it. And yes, you may want to do 100 sitting at once, but make sure you know what you're saying. Make sure you're concentrating. That will help you on the day of judgment. It's going to come on a very beautiful place that you need it on the day of judgment. But Allah tells us, you know what? On that day, you're going to be alone. We are never ever going to ask you about someone else. وَلَا تَزِرُ وَازِرَةٌ وِزْرَ أُخْرَى ثُمَّ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ مَرْجِعُكُمْ فَيُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. Allah says, no soul shall be burdened with what someone else did. Not anyone. What they did, Allah's not going to ask you, listen, come here. What did your neighbor do? Quickly tell us. No way. What did that guy do? No chance. What did you do? That's what Allah's saying. And Allah Almighty is telling us that then He will inform us on that day of our deeds. Because like I said, some, although we know what we did, over time we tend to forget. You commit a sin when you're 18. By the time you're 80, you may not remember. When we seek forgiveness, we say, أَسْتَغْفِرُكَ لِمَا لَا أَعْلَمُهُ. We know that dua, right? I seek your forgiveness for that which I don't even know. Either I can't remember it, or either I didn't realize I was committing a sin. My brothers, my sisters, one of the plots of shaitan is to make you commit sin while you're oblivious that you're committing sin. So we actually trivialize the sin without realizing, wallahi, it is massive. Backbiting is something that is a destroyer. It's a destroyer. When you backbite someone, the Quran says in Surah Al-Hujurat, أَيُحِبُّ أَحَدُكُمْ أَن يَأْكُلَ لَحْمَ أَخِيهِ مَيْتًا فَكَرِهْتُمُوهُ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. Would you like that one of you eats the flesh of his dead brother? It's detested. Allah says, he fear Allah, be conscious of Allah, you're coming back to us. Now, why is backbiting even worse? Because Allah is Ghafoorur Rahim. When you commit a sin between you and Allah, He may forgive you, He will forgive you. But people are not Ghafoorur Rahim. When you commit a sin against someone, Allah says, I'm going to call them and ask them, do you forgive this person or not? If they don't, then it's up to them and you. And that's what it is. They may take away your good deeds, or you may take away their bad deeds. And on that day, the currency is actually deeds. You want Jannah, Allah says, you pay. Not in rands, not in Zimbabwe dollars. Before, we used to make a mockery of the Zim dollar. Trust me, you guys are not too far off. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. 19 and a half, 20, I'm seeing the figures go up. May Allah protect us. But on a more serious note, the deeds, imagine you are told you need X amount of deeds to get into Jannah, and you are lacking by one small thing. Had you smiled upon the face of your brother, you might have made it in. Had you blocked yourself from backbiting, you might have made it in. But unfortunately, you see, when we are losing, we lose. Take it seriously. Allah says, when they accused Aisha radiallahu anha of immorality, na'udhu billah, in Surah An-Nur, that statement they were passing amongst themselves. Passing. In today's world, we call it forwarding. You know, you get a message about someone, you know, this and that, and you forward it. That forwarding, that's what we're talking about. Allah says, تَحْسَبُونَهُ هَيِّنًا وَهُوَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ عَظِيمٌ. You think it's something light. In the eyes of Allah, it is huge, humongous. You are hurting someone you don't even know. You're talking about someone you have no clue how close or distant they are from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How? And this is why we say, at that time, the people of the accusers fell into certain categories. The worst from among them was the one who created the tale. The one who created the tale. The head of the hypocrites, Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul. So Allah says, الَّذِي تَوَلَّى كِبْرَهُ مِنْهُمْ لَهُ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. He's going to have a painful punishment. The one who created the tale, and he was the head of all the mischief, he will have a painful punishment. But Allah says, لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ مِّنْهُمْ مَكْتَسَبَ مِنَ الْإِثْمِ. Everyone who was involved in that slander, everyone who was involved in it, will actually have a portion of the sin based on what exactly they did. Some of them forwarded the tale and they spread it. Some of them, what did they do? Some of them actually created more than what they was. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, there was a category from among them. As soon as they heard, they immediately said, this is a lie. Aisha radiallahu anha is pure and she can never do that. And they closed the topic there and then. Allah says, those are the true believers. لولا إذ سمعتموه ظن المؤمنون والمؤمنات بأنفسهم خيرا وقالوا هذا إفك مبين. The true believers, when they heard it, it was for them to say, you know what? This is a lie. This is a lie. It's a fabrication. Because if we can't do it, she's not going to do it. What would it cost you to think good of the other? One of the ways of your entry into Jannah, wallahi, is something known as husnul dhan, to think good of your brothers and sisters. You see someone walking, perhaps they might have tried to clean the street. It has happened in the past. And they moved a few bottles and you saw the bottle in the hand. I'm not trying to help those who have a drinking habit. Astaghfirullah, you need to get rid of it. But I'm saying not everyone that you might have seen at a certain place is guilty of committing the sin right to the end that may have been committed at that place. So go easy, think good. No, perhaps they were just cleaning up. No, perhaps they went to do this, perhaps they went to do that, in a good way. So what does shaitan do? Wallahi, he makes us oblivious of the day we're going to meet with Allah. That's the main plan. So you tend to forget, and you forget how serious it is. I'm not here to doom you. I am looking forward to the day of the meeting with Allah, and I have hope in the mercy of Allah. We are mu'mineen. We try our best. We do our best. And we have hope in the mercy of Allah because He will forgive us by His mercy. We look forward, but we are concerned. What's the concern? I'm a bit worried. You have to be concerned that may Allah accept our deeds. There's a lot of consolation in the Quran and the Sunnah. Can I give you one? Beautiful one. You see the magicians of the Pharaoh at the time of Musa alayhi salam, Moses, may peace be upon him. Those magicians, they were engaged in magic. Magic is shirk. Anyone who engages in it or orders it or instructs it or actually is involved in it, Allah says that's the one of the major sins, if not the biggest. Shirk. Man sahara faqad ashrak. Whoever has cast a spell has committed shirk. That's the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. But those magicians, when they saw what came in front of them as their little sticks and stones or sticks and ropes were actually swallowed, they immediately fell prostrate. They made sujood to who? For the first time, to Allah. And what did they say? We believe in the Lord of Musa and Harun. That's all they said.
قالوا آمنا برب العالمين رب موسى وهارون.
We believe in the Lord of the worlds, the Lord of Musa and Harun. May Allah's peace and blessings be upon them. Immediately Fir'aun threatened them and he told them, I'll execute you. They said, look, we don't mind. Do what you want. Whatever you're going to do, it's only going to be on this earth. As for after this life, you got nothing. No say, no control, no zero. So he executed them. How many sujood had they made? One. You follow? Allah says we gave them Jannah and paradise. How many sujood did they make? One. What did they say? We believe in the Lord of the worlds, the Lord of Musa and Harun. They were executed as a result. You and I, how many sujood have you made in your life? Wallahi, we don't know. Do you agree? We don't know every day. If Allah accepts one of those, don't you reckon there's good news for you and me? May Allah help us. May Allah grant us. I told you that there's a lot of good news also. You look forward to it. Ya Allah, accept my sujood. It's only for you. I can never, and none of us can ever, put our heads on the ground for anyone or anything besides He who made us. Don't you agree? Imagine going down on the ground. I can't imagine it. I'll never do it for anyone besides the one who made me. That's it. And if I've done it and I say, Subhana Rabbi Al-A'la, I already know I've declared the praise of my Lord. You are the greatest, you are the highest. Inshallah, He will accept it. What else? I have hope. This is Allah. So Allah tells us on the day of judgment, you're going to come alone. Yet on earth, you were worried about everyone else and not yourself. So I want to pause for a moment and I want to tell you, don't get trapped. People get trapped. Pious people get trapped. Ulama get trapped. Those who are generally practicing get trapped. Sometimes they get trapped more in this field and in this front than those who might not be that practicing. May Allah make us all steadfast on the deen. So you notice, what do you notice? People worried about others. They talk about what's wrong with you, but 10 things are wrong with them which they're ignoring. Allah says, on the day of judgment, we're not going to ask you about this guy. We're going to ask you about yourself. You find people uttering things, saying things about all others, but what about themselves? I told you the winner, the true winner, is the one who's worried about himself. Listen to another hadith. Tuba liman shaghalahu aibu an uyubin nas. Give news of a place in Jannah, a special place in paradise called Tuba, to the ones whose own weaknesses keep them occupied from engaging in the weaknesses of others. So what this means, I need to do nahi anil munkar, I need to remind people, but remind in a respectful way. Don't belittle, don't abuse, and don't insult. When someone is doing something wrong and you want to say something, be very calm. Allah tells you when you're speaking to the disbelievers and the enemies of Islam, speak to them with wisdom. In the case of the Pharaoh, Allah told the prophets of Allah. Allah said, go speak to him softly, nicely. Perhaps he might listen. And Allah knew he would not listen. Allah knew he's not going to come. But Allah told him, go speak softly, speak kindly, speak in a good way. Because Allah wanted to teach us that in your lives, you speaking to others. Sometimes I watch the politics between the scholars. And I feel to myself, subhanAllah, in our own fraternity, the language that's used. Allah denied Musa alayhi salam to talk to Fir'aun like that. Sometimes the titles we give one another, na'udhu billah, where is the concern for my qiyamah? Insha'Allah, I will never do that. Because if you're really and truly worried about that day, that's the biggest day ever. It's got so many scary names in the Quran. You would never ever open your mouth with a disrespectful term to refer to another believer, let alone a scholar. And this is why, من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليقل خيرا أو ليصمت. Here's the Prophet ﷺ, he clearly tells you, whoever truly believes in that last day and in accountability, I'm going to go back to Allah and answer for myself, they will only say good words or they will keep quiet. There's nothing else. You either say good words or you remain silent. Because if you get trapped by shaitan, you'll find yourself talking about others and so on. And when you want to correct them, you justify. I can insult, I can abuse, I can do. Because why? I'm doing their islah. That's an excuse. Wallahi, you need to do your own islah. If the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is not your qudwa and your leader and the one whom you are trying to emulate, then you need your own islah. You need to correct and rectify yourself. Don't be abusive. You can correct and disagree however much you want, but you've got to be respectful. You have to be a person who does not insult and abuse. The hadith says a mu'min is not someone who is fahish and badi, not a person who's abusive, insulting, vulgar, and so on. Today we are becoming like that. I am here to tell you, let's be concerned about our akhirah. Make dua for me. We make dua for you. May Allah gather us in Jannah. May Allah make that day easy for you and I. Do good deeds and continue to do good deeds. And don't waste them by doing bad deeds. And if you want to engage in the life of another, do so positively. And you see how Allah will bless you and your offspring. And learn to love. The ummah is going through challenges. We are mu'mineen. We are believers. Try to look for reasons why people are Muslim rather than trying to look for reasons why they are not Muslim. Because if you want to look for reasons why they are not Muslim, we are all sinful. Each one will stand in the masjid thinking, I'm the only Muslim. These guys are astray. You see, today this guy came to talk in our masjid. You know what? You better watch out. He's not even a proper Muslim. He does, you can't read salah behind. This type of thing, we hear it. Trust me, the losers, the only losers are the ones who have such dirty ideas. The rest of them, inshallah, we can benefit. I promise you, I want to end with one verse. I want to end with one verse that just came to my mind now. Very, very strong verse. You see, in Surah Al-A'raf, Allah talks about those people who used to say that the other people are not going to go to Jannah. Right? We get that in our communities, every community. They say, those guys know Jannah. These guys, Allah won't have mercy on them. Allah says in the Quran, He's going to call those people. And the other ones who used to say that He's not going to have mercy on them.
أَهَؤُلَاءِ الَّذِينَ أَقْسَمْتُمْ لَا يَنَالُهُمُ اللَّهُ بِرَحْمَةٍ.
Are these the people whom you guys used to say Allah's not going to have mercy on them?
Udkhulu al-jannah la khawfun 'alaykum wa la antum tahzanun.
In front of them, Allah will say, you go to Jannah, no need to fear, no need to worry. Yalla. This shows you that in the dunya, when people say, this one is like this, this one is like that, they have no idea. They have no idea. So you and I, what should we do? Do our own islah. Become a disciplined mu'min. From me, no one's going to be harmed. From me, no one's going to be insulted. From me, I will either help people and I will endure the crush that they might serve me. No problem. They are still my brothers. I still love them. I will still make dua for them. I still believe they are a part of the ummah. And I want us all to go to Jannah and we will laugh about how we used to mock at each other here. It's not worth wishing for someone to go to hell. May Allah purify our hearts. And may Allah bless you all. This community, I recall coming here before. And if I'm not mistaken, the masjid had once, some fire was in this masjid, am I right? Some time back. May Allah Almighty grant you all goodness and your communities. May Allah bring the hearts together and help you to respect one another. Aqulu qawli hadha wa sallallahu wa sallama wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad.